Hey guys, it's Tepco Cycle Repair. Today I'm going to show you how to fix one of these Fly Racing kill switches. You know, these are $45-something, so when they go bad, you know, you can just buy one. But for me, fixing these things and figuring it out is because I need it done now. And I want to take the bike ride and I don't have a kill switch, so let's figure it out here. So we have our tester here, all right, on continuity. So what you do here is you're going to take one on one side, one on the other, and I'll show you what's going on with the kill switch. So here's the kill switch here. We hit it. Nothing. I'm not getting anything. So these kill switches are waterproof and they're sealed. So when you look at the bottom of them, the wires are just going in. But to get to the switch, you just got to pry out this rubber button on the top. So just get a screwdriver. Just gently just pry it up. It'll come up. All right, and inside there you have the two contacts, and then you have a disc on the inside of the push button. Okay, so if you touch these two contacts together, if we do the same thing, all right, put our connections on here. Try to use one hand here. All right, and then we touch the two together. So now we know the wires and everything are good. We know the problem is going to be this button and this little contact patch in here. So we got to get that out and fix that. So it's just a disc. All right, so I'm just pulling that disc out, and you can see there's some just dirtiness and corrosion on it. So I'm going to scuff that clean. So we're going to get that all nice and clean. I'm going to work on that a little bit more. I want it to be nice and really shiny. Stand by. All right, so I got it all shined up there. And you can see if I put it on here and touch the two together, let me slide it over, you can hear it working. All right, so now let me get that. Just stick it back into the rubber cap. Got to get it back all the way into its tabs so it's not just floating in there. So we got that back on there. Stick it back into the kill switch housing. And which is cool too, it says stop on it. You can rotate it now. Now that you have it out, you know which way it's going to be mounted. You can turn this so that stop is actually facing you, because when it comes new, it's not. It's like sideways. So we're just going to go ahead and center it here, push it back in. Work it back into place. All right, now we're going to hook it back up to the meter, make sure what we've done has worked. All right, and repair has been complete. So that's pretty simple. These are nice switches. They're waterproof. You can pull them apart. That's how you do it. You can clean it out. It's real simple. It's just a contacting wire. So go ahead and take these things off, clean them all up. With the amount of corrosion in there, I'm going to pull that off and put a little bit of dielectric grease in there just to make sure that we don't have a problem with it again, and it doesn't get corroded again. So that'll be even better, because we don't want any moisture. I mean, there's no moisture getting in there, just corrosion over time, I guess. So I'm just going to put a dab of that on there and get it in here on the switch contact. And that's it. We are done. Hopefully you like this video, guys. It helps you get these switches back in order. Like I said, I need it because I need it now. Now this is done, I can throw it back on the bike and go riding. We are good to go. Please hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell for further notifications. Till next time, guys, this is Tepco Cycle Repair.